Hello dear students, welcome back. In the today's class, so I am going to discuss about the properties of inverse trigonometric functions. Okay, so let us see some elementary properties of inverse trigonometric functions. Okay, so see, so these are the some properties I wrote here. These all the properties works on the conditions, on the basis of some particular conditions, this condition. Okay, so this is nothing but including this closed bracket. Okay, so property number one, sine inverse of 1 minus x is equal to cosec inverse of x. Fine, it is possible if x is greater than or equal to 1 or x is less than or equal to minus 1. Okay, so second one, cos inverse of 1 by x equal to sec inverse of x. So this is also same. It is possible when x is greater than or equal to 1 or x is less than or equal to minus 1, and tan inverse of 1 by x equal to cot inverse of x. So this is possible when x is greater than 0, right? So these properties works on these intervals only. Okay, so other than these intervals they didn't works. So see the solutions, the proofs for this proof. First one, we have to prove the first one, sine inverse of x equal 1 by x equal to cosec inverse of x, right? So first one, let us consider this RHS. Let cosec inverse of x equal to y. So let consider cosec inverse of x equal to y. X equal to cosec y. Cosec y. So take this x as a 1 by x, this is equal to 1 by cosec y. Cosec y, I am writing those two in the denominator. Okay, next. So 1 by x is equal to the 1 by x is equal to the 1 by cosec y is sin y, right? Sin y. Take this sin to this side, only this sin to this side. So it will become sin inverse of 1 by x is equal to, remaining is y. Y remains. So sin inverse of 1 by x equal to the y means cosec inverse of x. Cosec inverse of x. So this is the property. So what we need to prove? So this is possible when x greater than or equal to 1 or x less than or equal to minus 1. So on the basis of the condition, this property will work. Other than this intervals, it doesn't works. Okay, sin inverse of 1 by x. So for these three properties, consider RHS, cosec inverse of x equal to y. So then x equal to the cosec inverse become cosec y. Take in the denominator 1 by x, 1 by cosec y. So keep 1 by x as it is. 1 by cosec is sin y. So I am taking this only sin to this side. Okay, it will become sin inverse 1 by x equal to the y. Sin inverse of 1 by x is equal to the y is cosec inverse of x, and the condition. Okay, next is second one. See, so consider sec inverse of y. Let us consider, so this sec inverse of x equal to y. Sec inverse of x equal to y. So x equal to sec y, right? Then take in the denominator 1 by x equal to 1 by sec y. Okay, so 1 by x equal to 1 by sec is cos y. Take this cos to this side, it will become cos inverse of 1 by x equal to the y. Okay, so y is nothing but a sec inverse of x. Cosec inverse of 1 by x equal to the sec inverse of x. So it is also for the condition x greater than or equal to 1 or x less than or equal to minus 1. Okay. So third one, tan inverse of x equal 1 by x equal to cot inverse of x. Okay. So third one, let this consider cot inverse of x. Cot inverse of x equal to y. Okay. So x equal to, it will become cot y. Okay, 1 by x, 1 by cot y, 1 by x, 1 by cot y is tan y. Okay, take tan to this side, tan inverse of 1 by x equal to the y, tan inverse of 1 by x equal to the y is nothing but a cot inverse of x. So this is result when it is true x greater than 0, unless x greater than 0. Okay, these are the sum first three basic properties of inverse trigonometric functions. So if for this third condition, if x greater than 0 in this third condition, if x greater than 0, so we will get cot inverse of x equal to the pi plus tan inverse x. So keep remember, very important one. Okay, so if x greater than 0, cot inverse of x equal to pi plus tan inverse of x. Pi plus tan inverse of 1 by x. So if x greater than 0, if x less than 0, so if x greater than 0, tan inverse of 1 by x equal to cot inverse x. If x less than 0, cot inverse of x equal to the pi plus tan inverse of 1 by x. Keep remember, very important property. So when x is less than 0, cot inverse of x equal to pi plus tan inverse of 1 by x. Okay. So similarly, we can prove for these others. So that is sine inverse of x equal to cosec inverse of 1 by x. We can prove cosec inverse of 1 by x when that is x minus 1 less than x less than 1 and x is not equal to 0. And we can prove similarly, so that is cos inverse of x equal to sec inverse of 1 by x, cos inverse of x equal to sec inverse of 1 by x. So on the condition x less than or equal to x is not equal to 0. And lastly, we can write tan inverse. So I will write here tan inverse. This tan inverse is tan inverse of x equal to the cot inverse of 1 by x if x greater than 0. Okay, and similarly, so if x less than 0, cot inverse of 1 by x minus pi if x less than 0. So similarly, like this we can prove these three properties: sine inverse of x equal to cosec inverse of 1 by x, cos inverse of x equal to sec inverse of 1 by x, tan inverse of x equal to cot inverse of 1 by x, x greater than 0, cot inverse of 1 by x minus pi if x less than 0. Okay, right. See the next properties. Sine inverse of minus x equal to the minus sine inverse x. So it is like sine of minus theta equal to minus sine theta. In the inverse trigonometry, it is sine inverse of minus x equal to minus sine inverse x. In the condition x belongs to the minus 1 comma 1. Second one, tan inverse of minus x equal to the minus tan inverse x, x belongs to the r. So as like tan of minus theta equal to minus tan theta, and cosec inverse of minus x equal to minus cosec inverse of x. So mod x greater than or equal to 1. Okay, so see the solution. Proof. First one, so let us consider sine inverse of minus x equal to y. So let us consider, take in this case, take LHS. Okay, so minus x equal to sin y, minus x equal to sin y, x equal to minus sin y. So I am writing this minus this side. Okay, x equal to, so take this of minus inside, sin of minus y. Sin of minus theta is minus sin theta. There is no difference in the sum. Okay, so take this sin to this side. It will become sin inverse of x equal to the minus y. So what is y? Sin inverse of minus x. Sin inverse of x equal to the minus sin inverse of minus x. Okay, so take minus this side, minus sin inverse of x equal to the sin inverse of minus x. So therefore sin inverse of minus x equal to the minus sin inverse x. So condition is x belongs to the closed bracket 1, 1. So very important proofs for 2 marks. Okay, so take LHS, sin inverse of minus x equal to y, minus x, this only remains. Take sin to this side, it will become sin y minus x. So x I am writing minus this side, okay, or else multiply minus on both side. Okay, x equal to minus sin y, this will become positive, this will become negative. X, take minus inside the angle, sin of minus theta is minus sin theta. On the basis of that, sin of minus theta, okay, minus sin theta can be written as sin of minus theta. Okay, so take this sin to this LHS side, it will become sin inverse of x minus y. So y is sin inverse of x, sin inverse of minus x. Okay, so this is y minus y. So minus, again take minus this side, okay, minus sin inverse of x equal to sin inverse of minus x. Okay, so sin inverse of minus x equal to the minus sin inverse x. X belongs to the minus 1, 1. Just rearrange it in the last step. Okay, so second one, tan inverse. So let us consider second one, tan inverse of minus x equal to the y. Okay, so minus x equal to the tan y, take negative to the RHS, minus tan y, x equal to the tan of minus y, tan of minus y, x is equal to the, so take this tan to this side, tan inverse of x equal to the minus y, tan inverse of x equal to the minus y means, so what is y? Tan inverse of minus x, tan inverse of minus x. So therefore we can write tan inverse of minus x equal to the minus tan inverse of x. So if x belongs to the R, this is our result, tan inverse of minus x equal to minus tan inverse of x. Next one, so third one, cosec inverse of minus x. So let us consider cosec inverse of minus x equal to the y. Okay, so x minus x equal to the cosec y, right? Then x equal to the minus cosec y, x equal to, take minus to the inside, cosec minus y. Okay, so take this side, cosec inverse of x equal to the minus y, then cosec inverse of x equal to the minus y means cosec inverse of minus x, cosec inverse of minus x. So therefore cosec inverse of minus x equal to this. So this negative to this side equal to the minus cosec inverse of x. So this is on the basis of condition mod x greater than or equal to mod x greater than or equal to 1, or else we can write this as a x greater than or equal to 1 or x less than or equal to minus 1, right? So this is the next property. Okay, see the next property is fourth. In that first one, cos inverse of minus x equal to pi minus cos inverse of x when x belongs to the minus 1 comma 1, close interval minus 1 comma 1. Sec inverse of minus x equal to the pi minus sec inverse of x mod x greater than or equal to 1. Cot inverse of minus x equal to the pi minus cot inverse of x, x belongs to the R, x belongs to the R. Okay, so see the proofs. First one, so consider this, let cos inverse of minus x equal to the y, cos inverse of minus x equal to the y, so minus x equal to the cos y, minus x equal to the cos y, then so take minus to this side, x equal to the, so x equal to the minus cos y, so this is equal to the, we know cos is negative in the second and third quadrant. Okay, so that's why I will write cos 180 minus theta is minus cos theta. Cos 180 minus theta is minus cos theta. Why pi I am taking? So in the result we have to prove pi, pi minus theta. Cos of pi minus theta is minus cos theta. Okay, so take cos to this side, cos inverse of x equal to the pi minus y. So what is y? Y is cos inverse of minus x. So cos inverse of x equal to the pi minus cos inverse of minus x. Okay, take this to this side and this to the here, right? Cos inverse of minus x equal to the pi minus cos inverse of x, pi minus cos inverse of x when x belongs to the minus 1 comma 1. So very simple but important for 2 marks. Okay, next one, sec inverse of minus x. Second one, sec inverse of minus x equal to the y, right? Minus x equal to the sec y, x equal to the minus sec y, x equal to the minus sec y, x equal to the sec of 180 minus y. So I am taking this minus to the inside the angle, pi minus y. So to write without changing the result, I have to take pi minus y, sec pi minus y is minus sec y. Okay, so it balances the equation. Now take sec this side, sec inverse of x equal to the pi minus y, sec inverse of x equal to the pi minus y is sec inverse of minus x, sec inverse of minus x. So take sec inverse of minus x here and this here, interchange these two. Okay, so sec inverse of minus x equal to the pi minus, so this to this side, sec inverse of x. So condition for this is mod x greater than or equal to 1, mod x greater than or equal to 1. Okay, so third one, cot inverse of minus x. Cot inverse of minus x equal to y. So let's just consider cot inverse of minus x equal to the y. Take this cot to RHS. So here remains minus x. Cot inverse will become a cot. Okay, cot y. Take minus this side. X equal to minus cot y. X equal to minus cot y. X equal to the cot of minus y. We can't directly. We can't write directly cot of minus y. That is pi minus y. Pi minus y. So x is equal to the take cot this side. Cot inverse of x equal to the pi minus y. Right? What is y? Cot inverse of minus x. Cot inverse of x is equal to the cot inverse of x equal to the pi minus y. Y is cot inverse of minus x. Pi minus cot inverse of minus x. So take a cot inverse of minus x here, cot inverse of x there. Cot inverse of minus x equal to the pi minus cot inverse of x. So cot inverse of minus x equal to the pi minus cot inverse of x. So if x belongs to the R, if x belongs to the R, right? So this is the fourth properties. Okay, so I'll continue the remaining properties in the next class. Okay, thank you.